Greetings, all nations. It is January 21st, 2023. I am Prophetess Brenda Saw Jesus. I come before you to fight on behalf of God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit, and to give my testimony in the last days. God sent me a dream of dreadlocks. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 31. The gray head is a crown of glory, if it be found in the way of righteousness. Years ago, I stopped putting perms in my hair, and I couldn't figure out what I wanted to do with it. Most Black people put perms in their heads because it's easier to manage. All kinds of asymmetrical bobs, Coretta Scott King, and Claire Huxtable looks. When I was younger, I would get my hair straightened with a hot comb. Everything was straight until I decided that I wanted to embrace who God made me to be. He knows what he's doing. You ever look in the mirror at yourself and say, enough is enough? Even to the constant plucking and arching of the eyebrows, we can maintain what God created and tweak it a little bit, do makeovers, but you will come to see that we really don't have to redo a perfect creation. We must embrace ourselves. After I stopped the perms, I kept doing all kinds of natural styles. It was fun at first, but I was just over it. I thought of civil rights leaders, and I loved Frederick Douglass's hair. He looked so free, but I don't think that style would work for me. I do like those round glasses Rosa Parks wore. That I will keep. Anyway, I was tired of trying to figure it out. Too busy and stayed in too much pain to just leave it to chance. So I prayed and I asked God to tell me or show me what to do with my hair. Not long after I asked, he sent me a dream of me in dreadlocks, and they were gray. My dreadlocks were so long that they touched my butt. I said, thank you, God. I first got a stylist to start my dreadlock journey. I had them for a short time and I took them out. I did my own dreads the next time. I used a tool that placed a knot in them so they would stay in, and they ended up breaking off. They had gotten to a good length too, and I had to end up cutting them off. I was holding on to them for dear life. This last time, I don't twist them as often because they will break off. I call them God locks because God sent me the dream, and I keep them in because he was so gracious to answer my prayer. With everything happening in the world right now, some of you may not see the importance of my testimony about hair. I give you this testimony so you will see that God is still answering prayers and working miracles while Satan is having his 5 minutes of fame. Yes, these are terrible times, but God allows Satan to test you. But God is still and always will be in control. Stay the course. Luke chapter 12. Verses 7 through 8 says, but even the very hairs of your head are all numbered. Fear not, therefore you are of more value than the many sparrows. Also I say unto you, whosoever shall confess me before men, him shall the Son of Man also confess before the angels of God. Amen. I invite all who are listening to be saved before Jesus Christ comes in like a flood. When you see him, it will be too late. Pray with me. Jesus, please forgive me for my sins. I believe you died on the cross and was raised for me. Please come into my heart and save my soul. Amen. For those of you who hear this and still don't believe, pray anyway and ask God to come into your heart and work with you.